So we have this effect that I haven't given a name to yet, but we're going to call time dilation, and you'll see why in a minute. And we have these equations relating the rates at which different clocks tick. Now actually, this number v over c, I'm going to stop writing v over c. Instead, I'm going to use this number or variable beta to represent the ratio of a frame speed to the speed of light. And as long as we're polishing things up, let's go one step further. And instead of writing t prime like this, let's pull the t out and give this quantity, in parentheses, its own name. And that name we're going to give, well, we've seen alpha and beta, it's time for the next Greek letter, is gamma. So now, our complicated equation becomes t prime equals gamma t. So actually, in order to understand what's going on here, we need to understand gamma a little better. So first let me tell you, without giving you much proof, and I'm sorry for doing that, that v, the speed that we can move, or that our frame of reference can move, well, it has an upper bound. It can't go any faster than c. It can't go faster than the speed of light. So we can go as slow as zero, stopped, or up to the speed of light, which means that beta is between zero and one. Though it can't be equal to the speed of light. I want you to tell me, what's the minimum and maximum value for gamma? So for gamma min, is the lowest possible value of gamma, was it as low as we want? Can it go to a negative a billion? Is the lowest possible value zero? Or is the lowest possible value one? Likewise, for gamma max, is the highest possible value that gamma can be, is it one, two, or can gamma max grow as large as we want? So that's two questions, select the best answer for each.